All right, I'm Ethan, and today we're going to be going around the halls asking people their favorite Halloween candy. What's your favorite Halloween candy?
Kit Kats.
Kit Kat.
Probably Twix.
Skittles, the tropical version.
Reese's.
Snickers.
Almond Joy, by far.
Kit Kat, easy.
Sour Patch Kids.
Probably Jolly Ranchers.
Gummy Bears.
Skittles.
Anything but candy corn.
Reese's.
Skittles.
Halloween Reese's.
It's got to be the Heath Bar.
The free kind.
Now that we got everyone's opinion on their favorite Halloween candy, tune in next week to see us try them. First, we're going to try the Skittles. All right, Adam, what do you think?
I think they're pretty solid, you know. It's always a unique experience with Skittles. A lot of flavors. You really taste the rainbow, like they say.
NHS is selling Candygrams October 22nd through 29th during lunch. Surprise your friend. They will receive their treat on Halloween during advisory. The cost is $1, or you can donate a non-perishable food item or paper product. All proceeds will go to Mommy's Haven and St. Vincent de Paul Food Pantry.
Since Halloween is right around the corner,
Lexi and I went to Goodwill and got cute and simple Halloween costume ideas.
Don't forget, during help session in the library, NHS offers tutoring over multiple subjects. Sign up using the link on your advisory agenda or scrolling announcements.
Welcome to In the Way with Trey.
And I'm Aaron.
For the rest of the Chicago Bears season, they have so far the toughest schedule in the NFL. I do believe that they will go 13-3, which is my personal prediction, but for the rest of the NFL, I would say they would go 10-6. What about you, Aaron? What do you think?
I believe if the Bears have lost to the Oakland Raiders, there is no way they're going anywhere above 9-6. I mean, 9-7.
It's a very solid prediction.
My prediction for the Packers season is going to be 13-3. We've only lost one game, and it's to the Eagles, and by far, we are the strongest team in this division. What about you, Trey?
To me, this division is tough anyways with the Lions doing what they are now and the Vikings. But with the Chicago Bears doing what they're doing, I think the Packers will go 10-5. Not 10-5, 10-6. Wow, that's great.
10-6, we've only lost to the Eagles.
Well, yeah, that's fair. But you're going to lose to the Raiders this week.
No, we are not.
I think you will.
There's no possibility. With our defensive line, no run game stands a chance against us. Now, to be fair, we have some pretty good cornerbacks, but everyone makes mistakes once in a while, right?
So do the Bears.
The Bears just suck.
They're 3-2 last year at this point.
You guys have a pretty stacked defensive line, yet Jacobs just ran right through you guys. And he also fumbled it, and you guys took it back for, a touchdown, right? Am I correct?
Yeah, it sounds.
Didn't you guys also get a bunch of penalties that got you this close to winning the game? But you still lost. John Gruden doesn't stand a chance against us. The Packers will win 33-20.
All right, got it.
21.
Who do you think is the better team, the Packers or the Bears?
I think the Bears.
Out of the total wins, how many wins do you think the Bears will have this season?
About 2.
Well, they already passed that, Austin. What about the Packers?
About 7.
Which team do you think is better, the Packers or the Bears?
I like the Bears, but the Packers are better right now.
How many wins total do you think the Bears will have this season?
13.
What about the Packers?
They're going to lose only like 3 games this year, so.
I put a spell on you, and now you're gone.
Hey guys, this is At the Movies with Kai here, and today I'm going to review on one of the great Halloween movies of all time. It's called Freddy's Puppets. And this movie is about Zachary Bates. He found a sister following the witch, and he was finding a sister who found the witch's house. The witches are called Sanderson sisters, and they kill the sister and turn Bates into a black cat, Santa. And 300 years ago, Max lit the black candle and summoned the Sanderson sisters. And he and Binks try to save his sister from the Sanderson sisters. What I think of this movie? Great movie. Love to watch this movie every year. Thanks for listening.
Good morning, LHS. Welcome to our 9th episode of Coach's Corner. Last week, our Red Devils were defeated by the 59ers with a score of 13-0. What occurred on the field that led to the 59ers securing the win?
You know, our defense came out and they played a great game. Offensively, we just weren't consistent enough. We weren't able to put together a drive, you know, and take advantage of any red zone opportunities we had, and we just let one slip away, and we let a great defensive effort go unrewarded.
So this next coming week, this Friday, we'll be playing the Hobart Brickies. What strengths, what skill sets do they have that our Devils need to look out for and prepare for this week?
I mean, Hobart's a veteran bunch. This junior class is the class they've been looking for and waiting for quite a long time. They're skilled, they're fast, they're speedy, they're physical. They're just a really solid team, especially in the skilled positions.
So next week, we begin the IHSAA state tournament, meaning that this week is our last conference game of the 2018-2019 season. What is it that you are excited for the last conference game this Friday?
Well, you know what? You talked earlier. We did lay a little bit of an egg last week against Andrain, but we still have our own destiny in our own hands. We can beat Hobart. We can still get a share of the conference title. So there's still a lot to fight for this week. We're still able to put a number up on the board with the victory. So, you know, we're focused, we're determined, and we're ready to give it our best shot.
So this Friday, Lowell will be headed to Hobart to lay down the Brickies. Be sure to come out, have fun, enjoy the game, and good luck this Friday.
Thanks, Blake. Have fun up here.
We'll see you next time on Coach's Corner.
So am I, oh my God.
Tell me those aren't the costumes you are wearing for Halloween.
I mean, you're kind of jealous about it.
Oh, they are so basic. This candy, mine.
Ow.
Are you too busy for spooky season? Are you struggling to find a halfway decent Halloween costume? Then this is the commercial for you, brought to you by that annoying Radio and TV One class. For this first look, get your friends to stick dozens of sticky notes all over your body. We call this look stupid. Don't try this. This is really dumb. For this next look, grab your favorite kitchenware and tape it to your body. Boom! You are some crazy person who likes taping kitchen utensils to their body. For this next look, get your baddest leather jacket on top of that awesome black t-shirt. Cook up some ramen noodles, slap it on your head, and you have the lead singer of Nickelback, Chad Kroeger. For this next look, find those black clothes that you used last week to rob your Aunt Shelley of $20. Slap them on, and now you are effectively a shadow. You can use this look to follow around your friends at school or follow around your crush. It works. I know from experience. We don't need to talk about that. And for this last costume, find some dark clothing. Lather on all the makeup in your collection, and you're a burning ball of hot gases. That's right, you're a star.
Johnny Spooks here with Spooky Tape.
This is really dumb singer of Nickelback.